together, repeat please, and experience of creation, which has the purpose of outlining a creative experiment organized by another group for the art students of Unicamp. Firstly, I'd like to present and give a little context of the group's work. Secondly, I will briefly explain our methodological approach, which is oriented by construction of what we call creative situations. And finally, I will detail the experience called the Repeat Please itself, its process and some of its results. Ornata comprises a professor research group that carries out research into contemporary jewelry, in which personal ornaments are designed as artistic items. In this respect, the jewel is regarded as an artistic object and released from the need to serve any decorative ends or materiality in terms of precious stones. Thinking of jewelry as being closely linked to art means replacing the idea of forming shape-material relationship by the idea based on motif support arrangement, where motif means desire and support means body. It's a question of shifting the interest from the object itself to the relationships that it engenders. Thus, this jewelry, which is created in the realm of arts, turns to the body as an emblem of its existence and the symbolic potential inherent in jewel, such as power, identity, affection, wealth, love, etc. Here we have an example, a Tiffany bracelet, a heart charm, and a photography made for an ornament. The sphere of action expanding in this subject, and the works aren't confined to the typologies of traditional jewelry, but can also be displayed in other ways, such as photography, video, or artistic performance. I give you some examples. First one is from Caroline Broadhead, named Veil. Is the beginning of this kind of jewelry, where the idea is to think about the place on the body, the jewel, where, and the materiality too. And the second one is from Otto Kunzi. It's a photography series. It's not a piece. And the name is Beauty Gallery, where he criticized the role of adornment of jewelry and talking about the idea of the jewel became a kind of framework for the beauty of the person who wear. And the last one is from Alexander Blank, named Memento Juniori, in relation to the Memento Mori, a kind of jewelry, Victorian jewelry. And the character of cartoons is a kind of critique of the way of our childhood runs today. Other two examples. I don't know if you are if you know something about this jewelry, this kind of jewelry. So I thought about this before. I thought about the experience that. That one is from Ted Note. It's a brooch, Mercedes brooch. He cut parts of a Mercedes, a real car, and made this brooch and necklaces at the end. The idea is to talking about the economic power of distinction and brandings and jewelry itself. It's a end consumer. And the last one is from Gilbert Stack. It's a movie. It's a necklace, but the idea is what is inside. He filmed a crucifix being dissolved in acid, and put the filming in a necklace made in an iPod. And the film runs in this gadget. And it's a kind of discussion about old religion symbols and the new one, religious symbols like Apple. Well, this is the kind of jewelry we are talking about here. According to Deleuze and Guattari, jewels are the effects that correspond to weapons. And according to the same philosophers, just take up their position on the body like pneumatic objects. That's the connection between Deleuze and Guattari and jewelry. They become, in this sense, moving vectors which are established in between different dichotomies, such as desire body, inner outer, individual world, myself, someone else. Such an approach is in common, especially in Brazil art schools. For this reason, the main proposal for Natas is to encourage reflection, debate, and above all, creation in the academic environment. The activities carried out since 2011 include the offer of selection courses for the artist students, the running of workshops with the artists from overseas, like Cristina Felipe, Jorge Manila, and Dionay Watt, and exhibitions of the artwork, the works produced. In order to plan contemporary jewelry courses, two actions must be taken into account. Firstly, to bring about an understanding of jewelry that goes beyond common sense, by highlighting its potential to act both as individual and social objects, which are able to mediate or interrogate relationships between desire, power, memory, and body. Secondly, there was need to employ strategies that could change the traditional concept of jewels. Therefore, it was necessary to devise a methodology which was aimed at deconstructing and the preconceived meanings of jewelry, allowing jewels to become an object and a subject for artist creation. To achieve this purpose, a number of unusual procedures were adopted, both on the fringes and within the essential area itself under consideration, where the arrangement was designed to shape a praxis which was called creative situations. This entails undertaking pedagogical activities designed for creativity. The creative situations is a kind of journey that starts off with the concept of the course, in discussions about the planning and aims which were intended to stimulate. This gave rise to the arrangement of a series of events in open space and time, together with experiments which are closely linked to what had previously had been planned. The events which drive the creative situation stem from the arrangement of its operational features, which should allow what normally occurs in the student's thought to be transcended, involve a distrust of knowledge itself, bringing about modes of subversion and provide an escape route from what's familiar to students. These are able to trigger off the series of changes that are required and lead the necessary movement for fostering creativity. This entails undertaking that the operational features don't set out a pathway that can be reproduced, but rather allow it to be traced and tracked at the same time, in the sense defined by Deleuze and Guattari. In this way, a kind of lack of control is deliberately established, which assumes to follow through and inevitably encounter a problem as though by accident. Bypass is part of such a grooming process, and for this reason, the prospect of renewal and rediscovery are always present. In the case of those who might be in a risk environment, which requires some answers to be given as a condition for putting the proposed work into effect, the unstable nature of the course can become a chance for creativity. Insofar, it gives rise to issues that are able to undermine fixed opinions and beliefs. What sort are the accidents? What arises, either disturbing expectation or is being conceived as potency. Hence, a form of action shaped into collective debates and divergence, which result in unexpected objects of which consistency resides in the fact that they must at that moment be regarded as concrete. Repeat, please, was a creative experiment carried out during the course The Body, Memory and Becoming, Encounters and Vestiges of Archaeology, in which the general proposal was working with the relationships between jewelry and the students, was recording a selection of poems or scraps by Ana Cristina Cesar, a Brazilian poet, as they repeated them twice a day for 10 consecutive days. The criteria used by Renato's professors for such a selection was based on a possible relationship between the poem and the students who would recite it. There are some examples for the poem, but it's important. It's only for show how short they were. The reading by the students should be governed by the way the text resonates with them and not by its interpretation. Just the recording of the student's voice would be relevant. Each recording had to be posted on the group's Facebook page every day. I couldn't show you some recorders, but the meaning of the poem is not to do about not the really meaning of the exercise, but the repetition. This is the group Facebook, and we can. The procedure involved producing something that could evoke or invoke from the body the concepts. The aim was to highlight in how time could be made tangible through the body by using the voice. The transformed speech gave rise to a word which would, in turn, be translated into an object. I show you one. And I show you must. It's not the last one, but we can use the difference.
To press the arrow on the left.
They've changed.
It keeps running away from me.
It's impossible. So we have a lot of these recordings for each student. During the theoretical discussions after the recordings, it was stressed that, in the repetition, it was important to be aware that something else was taking place during the intervals instead of simply what was repeated. There was a change to the pilot of which had been an intensive and not an extensive character. It was the intensity which struck one's as a difference, as well as a new encounter between the individual and the experience. In Deleuze and Guattari, I quote Deleuze and Guattari, repetition doesn't change anything in the object that's repeated, but changes something in the spirit that beholds it. So long as one lives, one's being marked by the past, present, and future. Existence involves the overlapping of these time periods, which are endured with memory. Difference and repetition and becoming are then associated with the notion of duration and change, in which beings conceive as an overlap, as a continuous construction in which the past and the present contract. After the theoretical approach, a collective listening to the reports was performed to compare the changes over time. In order to better realize the difference, Only the first and the last recordings were selected. During the listening, some keywords are compiled, which express the change in utterance between the first and the last recordings of each student. The resulting keywords are discussed among us in the group, and verbs that reflected the change were suggested, conjugated in the present continuous tense. For example, swallowing, settling, confining, mechanizing, artificializing, bothering, preaching, proclaiming, resigning, performing, etc. The students are asked to make an object for the body that was related to the verbs identifying the process. Using the concept of translation explored in previous exercise and not make a representation. As guidance for the development of the object, they thought about where exactly in the body it would be placed and what materials would translate the section well. I will show some results. There's from Victor, the verb was resign. He made two watches, one with a big crow inside, another with a small one. Both bringing the idea of timing, because the idea of repeat and repeat and repeat, and the time is contract, and the resign he related with the Kafka's book, the Metamorphoses. Here the image is not so. The other example is from Sabrina. The words are artificializing, and she made two kinds of masks. The mask idea is a dual subject. It has something artificial in the mask, in its appearance and its expression. The idea is not to cover the face, but made with something. It could be true, because it's not a mask in the real world, but a mask in the social life. We need to put some masks. The Lydian made object, the verb is confining. They made a kind of ring with a piece attached, and that could print a kind of secret message in the other person's palm when the hands shake. It's kind of confined. It's a surprise. And Fernanda, the words mechanizing, she did a metal plate piece. Two different kinds of mechanical operations were evoked. One is about the position of the piece in the body, and the other one, the mechanism attached. The way the movement of the head became mechanized in some way. And an artist made the saddening. She made an old, crumpled and faded head that evokes the action of time. And when we're bringing the idea of feelings of sadness, in her opinion. Well, that's the result of experience. The object presence showed unusual connections provided by the choice of materials and the way they were worked. And the relationships between the object and the body was also unexpected for first experience in art gallery from that student. Therefore, the unusual combination of different artistic and material language, together with the methodological approach to describe the both, contributed, in our opinion, to both foster imagination and stimulate creation in the art gallery field. It's our first experiment, and we are changing and making arrangements to develop this more and more. Thank you for your attention.
thinking about it. Chris? Especially when you hear of the construction of a whole program, creativity, based on such ideas.
I'm really interested in the combining of the infinitive verbs in this this sort of process of transformation or something. I think it's just an absolutely fantastic pedagogical idea, and you can see that it has a. What age are the students that you're working with?
18-20 years old. The first one in the German forest.
Mm-hmm. That's really, it seems it, the whole thing seems really sensitively combined. It's really, really considered on your part. And the results are genuinely really interesting.
Mm-hmm.
I might be stealing the infinity. I will credit you. That's really, really nice. Yeah. I don't have any criticisms, just to say thank you.
How much did you have to, or how much did you explain to the students the origins of your approach, of your structure?
What do you think about our approach?
The sort of philosophical basis, if you like, of your.
I made my PhD in art theory, and I studied the Leos in this kind of interesting job. It's a very small part in the 1,000 plateaus. And the idea of changing the focus in the object itself and putting the motif is the starting point to my research. And I'm interested in this kind of jewelry since before my PhD. In Brazil there are a lot of design jewelry courses, and I'm not interested in this. I'm interested in the potential, the symbolic potential inherent in job.
And do you explain this to students before they begin, or?
When it's an elective class, so when they started, I told you about this kind of job, what kind of job you do there, because many think about to make pearls necklace and things like that. So it's important to explain this. And the course is an experimental exercise, so they want to leave the
preconceptions.
Then it's like it's a risk for us and for them.
We have very similar contexts. I teach on a design and animation course, and it's trying to talk to sort of design oriented students about Deleuzean practice-based philosophies.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very difficult thing to do in terms of you can't. I find that if I'm explicit about it at the start, you often get a very kind of negative reaction. So you have to sort of do it subtly. And mm-hmm. Do you tell them where that framework is coming from initially, or your jewelry students?
I believe it. It's different to work with design students and art students. I teach for both, and the approach is very different in art and in design.
Exactly.
When we planned this exercise and course, we made some kind of theoretical collage with literature or a video or dance and other art fields with some theoretical and philosophical concepts. And we made some experimental exercises, like the recordings, and they didn't know where we are going through, but they buy the idea. And then we study some concepts in the theoretical texts. A small part, because it's not so hard, it's not a philosophy course. I'm not a philosopher, so I can't go into the inside, and they make some disorientation, kind of disorientation in his thoughts, and I think that's like the idea. And I put we put them to produce something very, very strange for them, because jewelry is an idea. I believe the combination of this both disorientation could be made some creativity, produce some creativity result. But they need to buy, because if they have someone they fear, it goes out and things like that, that's okay. Everyone's limit. We can do nothing about this.
I would like to ask you, how do you imagine these jewelers you showed to us? As you imagine them to be used in everyday life, or as contemporary objects to be exhibited in a gallery, for example?
The jewels made for the students, or this kind of jewel?
Let's say this kind of jewel.
This kind of jewel, the name of this kind of jewel is contemporary jewelry. There are some which is very crafty, beautiful crafty work. But this is mine, this is George Manila made for me. So I can use. But there are others one that you can use. There are some kind of, it's a photography, it's not a piece to put in on the body. And Gisbert to start necklace, I can use it. But every time you put in the body something like that, you provoke something in the other person. That's the idea of jewelry. But now we are so used with this kind of jewelry to beauty and things like that, and they don't affect us anymore.
So it's an alternative way of beauty.
Not of beauty, but to rescue the power of the jewelry, to express symbolical things important to humans, things like power, love, and a relationship, a memory. The jewels could mark moments in your life. That's the idea. It's a powerful thing. But now it's Barthes has a text, and they talking about the transformed jewels in accessories. They can be changed and changed. They lost their real importance.
So in a way, it's contemporary, but also more connected to ritual forms of perceiving them.
Yes, I think it's the contemporary is the word they use. I prefer art jewelry, because when is the boundary between an object and an art? I like the boundaries. Not to be there and not to be the other thing. It's kind of strange subject, or strange object.
Was kind of Bergson at work in your model of theory as well as Deleuze? Because again, a little bit like the last presentation, the way in which yours is. Seems more sort of complicated in the sense that a lot of it is about generating these new kind of affective forms, but it also seems to have one foot in models of memory and duration and the symbolic. I think kind of leans to a kind of like strongly Bergsonian version of Deleuze. I'm just wondering, when you were doing your PhD in relation to jewelry, were both of those voices kind of at work in your theory?
No, I became only in Deleuze's thoughts. I don't,
yeah.
Because I don't talk about memory specific in my PhD.
Okay. It's just because of how you were conceptualizing the jewelry as having a strongly imbued with memory or symbolic attachments and things. That's why it's interesting to me.
Is that thing to study?
Thank you, Annapurna. Thank you, all the speakers. We must draw a close, sadly, but it's been a fascinating session. Thank you.